Yo, you have a masterful flow.
Thank you.
The pattern is art. And there's not a lot of people that sit down and like study stuff like that, but like just following it and how you put it together and how it's able to make sense. There's some people who have that, but they don't always make sense and they jump from topic to topic. Mm-hmm. But you find the ability to stay within that pattern and stay on topic ever since the Raucous era. What would you say is the difference between that era and now?
Jesus Christ. Words.
I think you just summed it up.
Back then, they used to use their words.
I mean, when I was pre-Raucous, I was working with Jessica Rosenblum, and I was working with Diddy, and working with Funkmaster Flex, and running around promoting parties, putting up posters, handing out flyers. And so I was immersed in that sort of jiggy hip-hop world. But when I went home to Brooklyn, I was hanging out with Supernatural and people like that. And it was like the art was in Brooklyn, but the fun club shit was in the city.
The right. money.
Yeah, the money was in the city. Like right. we used to go to these clubs, and my whole crew was dancers. You know, DJ Talim, who used to dance for Brand Nubian, and had posted up a post. He was like, yo, back in the days, he wrote a post, he said, back in the days, you couldn't get by with the two-step. And I was like, nah, I get by with my two-step.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? But back in the days, my whole crew was dancers. I used to hold their coats. And I used to just peep. I couldn't dance, but I always wanted to be competitive. The Raucous era, what we did was we embraced vinyl when they was moving to the CDs, and we embraced paying tribute to the ancestors when everybody was trying to be new and flashy.
Right.
And so it became the anti-Bad Boy, even though that's not how I saw myself. Bad Boy was crushing everything, but I knew all the Bad Boy people.
Right.
But I was getting known in this circle of Raucous MCs, and there was an overlap. We did a Lyricist Lounge event. Mm-hmm. Big had just passed a couple of weeks before the event, and Puff came to the event. And Yasin did a record, Children's Story, that's on the Blackstar album, where he's criticizing some of the things that people might have accused Puff of doing in the industry. And Puff came backstage and had a conversation. He felt the way about that. And we told him, Yasin told him, the record is about sort of this ubiquitous character. He wasn't talking about one person in particular.
Right.
But it was like that. Like, Puff came to the Lyricist Lounge and had this conversation with us. But the fans separated it. And the fans, the backpackers, the ones, especially ones from out of town. We used to wear backpacks coming from Brooklyn to carry, whether you had a hammer or a pen to get a girl's name, number, or whatever. Like, the backpack
was gangster.
Functional.
Hammer.
Backpacking was gangster.
It was functional. Yeah.
Graffiti shit.
Hammer.
Graffiti, right. Whatever. Right.
Yeah. Just
right.
Right. Just hammer. Hey, yeah. My man caught in the gym sport. Right.
Yeah. But you started to have, after this Raucous Fat Beats era, you know, the Artifacts had a backpack and the book pack in the video. Grand Pooba had the backpack. So they start looking at these videos. So now you got white kids coming in from the suburbs wearing empty backpacks at the venue.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? And it became like a
thing.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. And then it's like, oh, you a backpack rapper. We was like, even though I was a nigga that used to wear backpacks all the time, I was like, no, don't call me that. Because I know what you implying.
What you mean.
Right.
Yeah.
What did it mean to you?
Backpack rapper meant you didn't have to be taken seriously because you were so underground, you weren't getting money. You weren't a part of the, like as the crew of dancers, we weren't buying drinks. We weren't drinking, we couldn't afford drinks. We go to the bar and be like, how much for water? And the bartender be like, $3. This was the early 90s. $3 for water? You know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah.
Fuck it. And you know what we do? Just be in the club thirsty for 3 hours.
Wow.
I thought about the other day. I was like, we used to just stand in that club.
Thirsty.
Thirsty.
Hot. Sweating.
Like, yeah, I'm going to the bathroom. You got to pee? Thirsty.
Nope.
Yo, wait till we get out to the pizzeria or to Mahmoud to get a Sunkiss.
Right.
Sunkiss. Here we go.
We're going to get to that Sunkiss.
Hold on.
We're going to talk about the Sunkiss.
Because
I witnessed something. Nah, they don't get no free promotion.
And I was outraged.
No free promotion for Sunkiss? We do love Mahmoud, though. So shout out.
This hot for trap trapper turn smack rapper. Smack. Only smack rapper that you know is smack rappers. Got bars I can hang with the backpackers. Trap star, I don't hang with the backpackers. I'm in the hood with the work, you heard. Making fiends leave earth, you heard. Got your baby mama thirst, you heard. Feel